Here it is, it's October 15th, and we're planting ginseng, and you might say, why are you planting this crop in the fall? Why don't you plant it in the spring, like most things are planted? Well, the problem is ginseng can't really be planted in the spring if you live in the north. And the reason for that is the ginseng seed, which has gone through an 18-month stratification period, once that seed cracks, once that embryo is fully mature, it requires one more cold treatment, and then the seed will germinate, and you cannot hold it. You cannot store the seed. So if you were to hold on to that seed, let's say it's October 15th, if I was to say I'm going to plant the seed in April, so I store it in my refrigerator, sometime in February or March, that seed is actually going to start to sprout anyway. And once it's sprouted, it cannot be planted. So we really have no choice but to plant the ginseng seed in the fall preceding the spring that it's going to germinate. If you harvest the berries and plant them immediately on site, as you should do, well, those seed won't come up the following spring, but they'll come up the year after that. So it's a little bit complicated, but you, generally in the north, you have to plant ginseng seed, usually sometime between August 15th and October 15th, or in this case, probably November 15th, although that's getting a little bit late. Any type of fall planting is fine until the ground freezes. After that, the seeds just tend to freeze out. What sometimes happens is if you get your seed and you immediately refrigerate it, you can sometimes put that seed back in dormancy and it won't grow until the following year, but you can't hold ginseng seed over, which is a real problem in terms of procuring the seed. It's like I can buy tomato seed that's 5 years old and it's still going to grow. You can't buy five-year-old ginseng seed. It just won't grow. It's dead by that point. Preparing a ginseng site in the forest can be quite a challenge. Depending on the site that you're working, most woodland sites, particularly up here in upstate New York, have lots and lots of rocks, and you obviously can't go in and pick every single rock that's in the forest. So you have to kind of work around the outcroppings of rocks. You also want to remove vegetation that's going to compete with the ginseng, which would include a lot of the understory shrubs. Even if they don't compete with them physically for nutrients, they're providing, in some cases, too much shade. So you try to get a rough idea of removing enough small trees and brush so that you allow enough sunlight in for the ginseng to grow well, but not too much sun to get in so that the ginseng burns up and doesn't grow properly. Typically, in the fall of the year, the ideal time to plant ginseng would be right before most of the leaves fall off the maple trees, because you do need to mulch the ginseng with the fallen leaves. So typically, in a wild simulated situation, what we'll do is we'll rake back the leaves, generally rake them uphill, because it's easier to get them back on the beds after that, as far an area as we can develop. If it's 25 foot long, that's great. If we can do a 4 foot wide by a 25 foot long strip, rake the leaves above that, and then broadcast the seeds. We're trying to plant about 5 seeds per square foot with the hope that 3 or 4 years later, through natural attrition, we'll end up with 1 plant per square foot. That way the foliage isn't touching and we don't have to worry so much about diseases. So let's say a 4 foot by 25 foot area, which would be 100 square feet, we would plant about 1 ounce of seed in that. It's about 500 seeds in 1 ounce. So again, that works out to about 5 seeds per square foot. The seed is broadcast on the surface of the soil. But as I said, the leaves are raked off, and typically we'll go in with a tool to scratch up the soil, because you do want to ensure that there's contact between the seed and the soil. So after we broadcast the seed, try to uniformly broadcast it by hand. We'll then walk on those beds to make sure that the seeds are pressed into the soil. You don't want to plant the seeds, say, 1 inch deep. They won't grow at all. So you really want the seeds to be just lightly covered with soil, maybe 1/2 inch of soil on top of them. And then it's a matter of raking the leaves back on top, hoping it rains, or hoping that more leaves will fall to cover them and provide the winter mulch. I don't think you can have too much mulch, natural mulch on ginseng. I've seen ginseng seedlings push up through 6 or 7 inches of leaf tissue, but the type of leaves is also important. Maple leaves tend to break down, and so 4 or 5, 6 inches of maple leaves is not a problem. Oak leaves tend to pack and compact. So ginseng seeds won't push up through 1 inch or 2 of oak leaves. They'll basically be smothered, but they will come up through 5 or 6 inches of sugar maple leaves. So the overstory trees are very important in terms of site preparation too. It's another reason why we tend to avoid oak sites, because of the tannic acid that's in the oak leaves. Sugar maple leaves have calcium in them. That's a good thing. Oak leaves have tannic acid in them. They pack down, they compact, and that's a bad thing.